Hey, what's up? I got a update for you guys today. I'm going to be redoing the tank, basically. It's been going through a couple algae problems, and I'm just kind of trying to clean up the tank, get rid of any of the possibilities that might be causing it. So I'm gonna be getting rid of the deep sand bed, just cause I don't really think it's doing much good for me right now. I don't really see too much life in the sand, and I think it's a big plus if I get those extra couple inches of viewing instead of just the sand in the bottom. It's kind of why I'm filming from back here, so you can see the before and after from when I get rid of all that sand. So I'm planning on leaving maybe 1.5 to 2 inches of sand at the end, and I'll try showing you the process and all that too. I'll try to edit it together, see what I can do. But yeah, there's a lot of this red algae on a lot of my rock. There's this green stuff too. I'm pretty sure that's cyano on this one rock, but all this other red is different. I forgot what it's called. And the glass in the back is covered in green algae. I already cleaned up these rocks in the back, trying to help it out before, but it's not happening fast enough, so I'm gonna clean some more right now. But yeah, there's a lot of algae back here. The coral is doing fine though. I just fed everything a whole mess right now, since I was gonna do a big maintenance day on this, I guess. So I wasn't too worried about dirtying the water too much. Everything's all full and stuffed right now. Yeah, there's algae on a lot of rocks. And you can see back here, see all the algae back there. And there's my sump. The sump pump is off right now. It's only the power heads are running in the display tank. All this is off too. This thing got covered in coralline algae. Alright, so I will update you guys right now when I start taking all this sand out. One last good look.
There.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever wondered how your DNA might impact your health? At 23andMe.com, you can order your in-home DNA kit and explore your unique genetic traits, health, and ancestry with over 200 personalized reports. Find out why 250,000 people have joined 23andMe. You might learn valuable health information. Click this ad to order your 23andMe kit today and save 20% on all additional kits you order.
All right, so there is my mess so far. I took out basically a whole bucket worth of sand. There's no rocks in there, just sand. All my rock is in here. Most of the rock is in there. There's my dirty power heads. And ended up having to put all my fish down here, because it got too cloudy on top. So I think that should be cool for now, because I can't see anything in there. So I'm gonna leave it like that, and hopefully it's cool. Scrape the glass in the back. All kinds of junk. And there's my mess so far. There's that sand. A little bit more sand in that bucket. Alright, so gotta keep on going, and after I gotta save all these damn snails from the sand. So that's it right now. Gotta make up a bunch of water to fill it up. Alright, so most of the work is done. I just turned on the system. Only the circulation pumps are on basically right now, the sump pump and the two Corellia power heads on the top. The skimmer is off right now. And it ended up being a 15 gallon water change I had to do on this from removing all that sand. So I'm gonna let this circulate for a little bit and wait till it clears up, and then I'll try to do the rescape up here after it clears up.